In this question, it says n moles of an ideal gas with constant volume heat capacity CV undergo an isobaric expansion by certain volume. It is asking the ratio of work done in the process to the heat supplied is. So here we know in isobaric process, we have work done in isobaric process can be directly given as P delta V, or this can be written as NR delta T, as pressure remains constant. So here we are having work done, and if we talk about the heat supplied, then heat supplied can be calculated by using first law of thermodynamics as delta U plus W. So delta U is taken as NCV delta T. Work done, we are having it as NR delta T. So this is delta Q. So if this is equation 1, this is equation 2. So from 1 and 2, if we are required to calculate the ratio of work to heat supplied, so it is work by delta Q. This is NR delta T divided by NCV delta T plus NR delta T. Simplifying this, giving us a value, delta T gets cancelled out. This is giving us NR by CV plus NR. So in this situation, the value we are getting is NR by NCV plus NR. Because N also gets cancelled out. So here, if we just have a look on the given situation, then none of the option is matching, but still the closest match we are having in this case is option C. Yeah, one thing we can also see in the question, it is given constant volume heat capacity. We have taken here CV as molar heat capacity, that's why NCV is taken. So if we talk about constant volume heat capacity, then NCV can be replaced only with CV, what is given here. So if CV is molar heat capacity, here we'll get NCV, and if it is constant volume heat capacity, so this is the product of NCV. So this is the exact answer, not just the closest match.